Greetings, ghosts and ghouls, and welcome to another Lights Out Storytime with the Houston Public Library. My name is Rachel, and today I will be telling you a real scary story about a haunted doll named Robert. Although this story is scary, it should be appropriate for children ages 10 and up. Are you ready? Once, many years ago, there was a little boy who lived in Florida named Robert Eugene Otto, but he just went by Gene. Gene was an only child whose parents loved him very much, but he was often lonely being the only kid in his parents' big, big house. The grown-ups around Gene noticed this, and they felt sorry for the lonely little boy. For his birthday, his grandfather gave Gene a special doll to be his new best friend. The doll was life-sized, as big as Gene, and filled with straw. He wore a little sailor's outfit and had a strange face that didn't look quite happy. Gene immediately loved the doll and wanted to take it everywhere with him. He named the doll Robert after himself and dressed the doll in his own clothes so they would always match. Not long after the doll's arrival in the house, Gene's parents began to notice strange behaviors from their previously sweet and polite little son. One night, they walked by his bedroom door and heard Gene having an argument with someone from behind the closed door. His parents panicked, worried that someone had broken into the young boy's bedroom. But when they ran into the room, there was only Gene sitting on the floor with a troubled look on his face, next to Robert, the doll. "What was all that noise?" Gene's parents asked. "Robert was being mean to me, and I yelled at him to stop," Gene replied, voice quavering. "Gene, don't be ridiculous. Robert's just a doll. You're letting your imagination get away with you," his mother snapped. She was upset that her son had worried her for no reason. "Now put your doll away and go to bed." So Gene put his doll away at the very back of his closet, closed the door, and sprinted to his bed. When his mother went to wake him up the following morning, she saw Robert the doll sitting on the pillow right next to Gene's head. She figured that her son must have come to his senses and gotten the doll out of the closet after being put to bed last night. She hoped that it would be the end of Gene and Robert's problems. But it only got worse from there. Gene began to throw fits every day and have night terrors whenever his parents put him to bed. His parents would come into his room at night after hearing Gene screaming to find toys and broken furniture toppled all throughout the room. No matter how much they yelled at Gene to stop or punished him with timeouts, the madness continued. Gene insisted that it wasn't him causing the problems, but rather it was Robert the doll. Soon the destruction spread beyond Gene's bedroom and into the rest of the house. The maids and cooks would find mutilated toys hidden throughout the house, which Gene claimed Robert had destroyed. There were action figures with their heads popped off hidden under the couches, and comic books with big black X's drawn over the hero's eyes at the dinner table. Anytime the house was quiet, they could hear the faint echo of laughter from a little boy. Even when Gene was at school or visiting his grandparents, the family and their staff would see the shadow of a little boy running this way and that, always just out of their line of sight. Robert the doll would appear in strange places, and everyone would swear up and down that they hadn't been the one to move him. Eventually, frightened of the doll's hijinks, Gene's parents locked the doll in the attic so it would bother their son no more. Then the haunting stopped, for a while. Many years passed. Gene grew up and moved away to become an artist. He lived in Paris for a while as an artist, and he married his wife, Annette. After his parents passed away, Jean inherited the mansion where he had grown up. Now an adult, Jean moved back into the house of his childhood, where those many strange hauntings took place. The first thing he did? Take Robert the doll out of the attic and begin spending time with him once more. Jean spent long days alone in his mansion, painting with Robert the doll by his side. Many times his wife asked for Jean to donate the old doll or throw it away, and every time Jean refused. Whenever people in the town would ask about the artist and his doll, his wife would avoid the question and simply say that her husband was eccentric. Although no one knows exactly what happened between them or what other hauntings took place while Jean lived in the mansion, Jean died with Robert the doll right there by his side. Robert the doll is now on display in a museum in Florida. You can go to the museum and see his strange, deformed face. But beware if you do go see him. People who take pictures of Robert without asking permission first become cursed by the doll. The walls around his glass case are covered in letters from museum visitors begging Robert to lift the curse that he placed on them and their families. If you go looking for photos of Robert, especially close-up photos that look into the doll's eyes, be warned. You could end up cursed too. Thank you for joining us for another Lights Out story time with the Houston Public Library. Follow us on social media to get more spooky stories brought from our libraries straight to your house. Until next time, bye.